What's good, y'all? T in this thing. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to expand a picture in Photoshop. Let's get it. All right, so you might be asking, what do you mean expand a background or expand a picture in Photoshop? I can show you better than I can tell you. So let's get into Photoshop. So this is a picture that I did last week of Honey Photography. If you haven't seen that video, you can go ahead and check it out just to see how I got this photo. The original photo that I got of this looks like this, right? Even if I wanted to crop this picture, there's no extra headspace in order for me to expand. And I wanted to try something new and get this honeycomb and bees and things like that. But again, I didn't have any headspace in order for me to get the photo. Because if I just add the honeycomb, it was pretty much on my forehead and it just looked ridiculous. There's so many ways how to expand it, but I'm gonna show you the quickest and easiest way that I know how. So this is what it looks like without the edits, but the headspace that we are going to get today. Going to the original, again with no headspace, what you wanna do is click on your photo and hit C on your keyboard to get the crop. Now, this is when you wanna crop it to how much you want. So maybe you want more picture or to stretch it out on the side. So you just go ahead and stretch it out on the sides or the bottom, whatever. But what I want is just that headspace. So I'm gonna go ahead and drag it up just a little bit. Oh, right here is fine. Hit enter to get the crop and let it do its thing. Now you're gonna see the transparency of the crop that you just made, right? So we're gonna go ahead and just zoom out a little bit. Now, obviously it's not like, okay, all right, you guys, it's done. You don't have anything there. So what you wanna do is make sure your photo is selected. So if you have any other edits or any extra pictures, anything like that, just make sure that the picture that you wanna stretch is selected. Then you wanna go up to edit and content aware scale. So if yours is like mine right now and content aware scale is grayed out, you probably have to rasterize. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. Rasterize, whatever. You have to rasterize the layer. So you wanna right click on your photo and it's gonna be rasterize layer. Click that and then you'll be able to go up to edit, content aware scale. Now it's gonna select your picture. All you wanna do is drag it up. Now keep in mind, you don't wanna just drag it up because then your head looks like a freaking, I don't know, a bean or something, a freaking long head. So you don't wanna drag it up too much. You just wanna drag it up ever so slightly until you start seeing something warping. So I'm looking at my little flyaways and you can see it's starting to warp. So I'm gonna drag it down to where it's not warping and hit enter. Obviously, I don't have that much headspace that I want. So you're just gonna do it again. Go back up to edit, content aware scale, and do it again. A little bit more until you start to see some warping. All right, drag it down, press enter. Okay, we're almost there, not quite. Do it again. Edit, content aware scale, drag it up, boom. I'm good right there. Enter, and there you go. Now, depending, some pictures, if you have different objects and things like that in the back, it may be a little bit hard or you may not be able to do it. Just depending on how much stuff you have going on, it may warp it. But that's the easiest way that I know how. But yeah, that's what I did for my last video with the honeycomb, because I didn't want just the honeycomb sitting on my forehead. So the content aware scale helped me tremendously. And if you want to see the latest video on how I got this sticky picture here, go ahead and tap or click on the video. All right, y'all, I'm out.